is formed. Here, bonding molecular orbital is in higher energy, lower energy, and antibonding molecular orbital is in higher energy due to out of phase overlapping or interaction. And we have also discussed about the molecular orbital diagram for simple molecule like H2 diatomic molecule and HE2. And we have given you the question to calculate the bond order of H2 minus, H2 plus, and HE2 plus. Probably you have calculated that one. Here, let me explain it. In case of HE2 minus, you have to consider an extra electron. That is, number of electron for HE2 minus is 3. And you have to fill the 3 electron in the molecular orbital. So 2 in bonding orbital and 1 in antibonding orbital. Bond order is 2 minus 1 by 2. So 1 by 2, half. Bond order is half. For HE2 plus, it is 1 electron less. Here also the bond order is half. And for HE2 plus, in case of HE2 plus means 1 electron is less. Here also bond order is half. It is similar to H2 minus. Sorry. Okay, so as we have here, we'll discuss about the homonuclear diatomic molecule. Homonuclear means both of the atom is same. Homonuclear diatomic molecule, two atom, both atom is same. like Li2, O2, Fe2, Be2. Those molecular orbital for those molecule we'll discuss here. Okay. So here you can see in here when A2 is Li2 and Be2. You can see the molecular orbital diagram. For Li2, only 2 electron. So it is having 1s2, 2s2. And we have not considered the 1s here. However, you can also consider the 1s below that 2s to have the same diagram. Okay. You can draw another label to show the 1s, like this. You can show the 1s like this. As it is diatomic, so you have to show like this. So 1s you can show. In 1s, they will form one bonding and one antibonding, similar to 2s. And here 2s have shown. In case of lithium, it is having the 4 electrons. So it is having the configuration, 3 electrons, 1s2, 2s1. Okay. So in case of lithium, it is having 1s2. The sigma bonding and antibonding having 2 electrons each. Then in 2s, one electron from each of the lithium placed in the bonding cell or bonding molecular orbital. Sigma bonding molecular orbital. Here is the electronic configuration molecular orbital. So sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2 and sigma 2s2. And sigma star 2s is 0. So as sigma star 2s is 0, so 2 by 2 equal to bond order 1. And we will have, as it is paired up, so it is diamagnetic in nature. Okay, so lithium to exist in gas phase. It is exist in gas phase. In case of beryllium-2, Be2, for this here the number of electron increases. This is 1s2, 2s2. So here the bond order is 0. So molecule is not possible, does not exist. It is monoatomic in gas phase. Okay. So, simple molecular orbital diagram you can draw for the homonuclear diatomic molecule. But it becomes little bit complicated when we are considering the A equal to beryllium, boron, carbon and nitrogen. That we will discuss later. First, we will discuss the A2 for O2, F2, Ne2. For those molecules. And we know that oxygen is having the P4 electrons, fluorine is having 2P4, fluorine is having 2P5, and neon is having 2P6 electrons. Okay. So here, if we draw, this is the general molecular orbital diagram. Again, here 1s have not shown. It is shown from 2s, valence cell. Only we have shown the valence cell. However, you can show also the 1s below that 2s. Similar structure, you can draw another one and give the name 1s, 1s. Okay. So here, sigma 2s, sigma star 2s, and 2p. Remember that when you are drawing the 2p, please think about the px, py, and pz orbitals. those are directed towards the axis. So when one p lobe is overlapping along the axis, two other p lobe must overlap above and below the axis. That should not be along the axis. Only one p lobe may overlap along the axis. Other two p lobe must overlap laterally. Is it clear? And that is why they will give the p pi orbital. And so you can see 2p2px, sigma 2px, say we are considering it is overlapping on the p axis. So it is sigma 2px and sigma 2px star or antibonding, which is higher energy than the pi orbital. Pi orbital energy is in between the sigma bonding and antibonding, because sigma bonding is strong than the pi bonding. Similarly, pi antibonding is strong than the sigma antibonding. So here is 2p, pi 2py and pi 2pz, because two other p lobe is available. So two pi bonding is possible, similar to pi antibonding is possible. I think it is clear to you. The figure is clear to you. Now, if you fill the electron, oxygen, say we are considering for oxygen. As I have already mentioned, oxygen is having the electronic configuration. Here you can see oxygen is having electronic configuration of 1s2, 2s2 and 2p4. So if we fill the electrons, forget about 1s, starting from 2s, so sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, and here is the 4 electrons. So 2 in this orbital, here 2 in this orbital. Okay.
Sir.
So, yes, please.
Yes, sir.
Do you have any query?
No, sir.
Sir, in p overlapping, how do you arrange the pi and sigma energy level?
Sorry?
In 2p overlapping.
In 2p orbital?
Sir, in 2p orbital. How, yes, sigma and pi orbital is arranged? Yes, sir.
See, sigma overlapping is on the axis. So this sigma bond is stronger than pi bond. Is it clear? So that, yes, is, sir, why the sigma is having lower energy.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? Similarly, yes, antibonding interaction is stronger than the pi antibonding interaction. And that is why it is above the pi antibonding.
Yes, sir, clear. Yes, sir.
Now 2p is having 4 electrons here. Okay, 4 electron means,
yes, sir,
4 from this and 4 from this, total 8 electrons. So you have to place 8 electrons, 2 here, here 2, 6 electrons. In 2px, 2 electron, 2py, pi 2py, 2 electron, pi 2pz, 2 electron. And now, when you are going to fill here, you should not pair up them. Why? Because as the orbital energy is same, Pauli exclusion principle, they should placed in singly occupied. So 2PY and 2PZ should have the single electron, not pair up in pi orbital, because this is the same energy orbital. So first they will take the single electron, then if available, then pair up. Is it clear? And that is why the oxygen molecule is paramagnetic. It is not diamagnetic. Is it clear? As we have already mentioned that it is unable to explain why oxygen is paramagnetic from the hybridization theory. Here is the explanation that two electrons in the molecular orbital are unpaired in the pi star orbital, and that is why this is paramagnetic in nature. And if you calculate the bond order, so here it is cancelled, here bonding is having 6 and antibonding is having 2. So 6 minus 2 by 2, 4 by 2, 2. Bond order in oxygen is 2. Is it clear? Now, in case of, here is the oxygen electronic configuration. It is paramagnetic because of single electron present. Okay, and valence bond theory and hybridization theory could not explain the paramagnetism of oxygen. Now, in case of oxygen plus or oxygen minus, we may draw the, it is possible to draw the electronic, molecular orbital diagram as well as electronic configuration. Here is for oxygen 2 plus, one electron is less for oxygen 2 plus. So, one pi star py electron is absent, zero. And so, bond order is increased, 2.5. Okay, so it is stronger, bonding is stronger than O2. And you can also see that fraction bond order is possible. And O2 minus, it is weaker, having the bond order of 1.5, because extra electron is added in the antibonding. And now you can see one of the orbital is having two electrons. Electron is paired up when extra electron is available. And that is why bond order for O2 minus is decreased 1.5, and it is weaker than O2. Is it clear? In case of F2, the electronic configuration is like this. It is very similar to O2, and for F2 here is 5 electrons. So you have to add another one extra electron here and here. So 2P star X2 and 2P star Y2. Antibonding is also all is paired up, and bond order is, here is 6 minus 4, bond order is 1, and it is diamagnetic since no unpaired electron present. Is it clear? And in case of neon, like helium, the same electronic configuration you will get, bond order is 0, as it is inert gas, and bonding is not possible here. Okay. So here you can practice the example, draw the molecular orbital diagram for peroxide O2 2 minus and calculate the bond order. Based on this, do you expect that O bond is in peroxide to be longer or shorter than in oxygen. Longer or shorter means if the bond order is high, bond is shorter. Bond order is less, bond is bigger, or length is higher. Is it clear? Because as length is higher, the bond is weak, and as it is shorter, it is strong. Is it clear? So you can try to solve this question and draw the MO diagram of FO2 plus and determines its bond order. For plus, you have to count one less electron, and for minus, you have to count one extra electron. Is it clear? And here you can see for O minus we are considering one extra electron in any of the center. Okay. Now, if why we have not explained for boron, carbon and nitrogen, especially for boron, carbon and nitrogen. For beryllium we have explained, but beryllium may be included in this series also. Even oxygen, those are the borderline. So you can consider beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, or boron, carbon, nitrogen. Especially for boron, carbon, nitrogen, when we are considering the B2, with the above figure, we may consider above figure for the B2, but the problem is here it is showing B2 is paramagnetic without having lone electron as per the diagram. If we consider the B2 for this diagram, B2 is having, it is having electron after beryllium, so 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, and when we are considering 2p1, it is paired up in the sigma. Is it clear? So it should not be paramagnetic, but from the experiment it is paramagnetic in nature, which is not explained from this diagram. So to explain that, here we have considered the hybridization theory, that mixing up of the closely spaced s and p orbital to give s px mixing, and as two orbital is mixed up, we have already explained in hybridization theory, they are giving two hybridized atomic orbital, and then it is forming the bond. Here in the diagram you can see that this is hybridized, mixed up, or it is explained in two ways, considering the hybridization or without considering the hybridization. Better explanation is considering the hybridization. How to explain without considering the hybridization? That as sp orbital is having the close energy, so due to this sigma 2px and sigma star 2s, these two sigma bonding orbital is over, means having strong interaction between them due to close position, and that is why the sigma bonding orbital having higher energy is increased with respect to the pi orbital. Pi orbital energy now becomes lower than the sigma. This is when we are not considering the hybridization. Okay, here you can see that the boron carbon nitrogen, the distance of energy is very less, 5.7, 8.8 and 12.4. From oxygen onwards, it is 16, 18 increasing. Okay, so when it is 2s and 2p is closely spaced, in that case, the sigma 2s and sigma 2px having the interaction, and that is why energy of 2px is increased and energy of pi 2py 2pz is decreasing relative to that. And that is why they are placed below the sigma 2px. But upper level remain as same. The explanation is clear to you? So if we consider the Be2 electrons molecule, the number of electron in Be is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So here 2s2 pair placing bonding antibody, and 1 electron from each boron coming in singly occupied 2p, pi 2py and pi 2pz. And that is why, although having 2 electrons, but they are unpaired. And that is why it is paramagnetic, not diamagnetic. Is it clear? But better explanation is by considering the hybridization. Okay, you may see the figure is little bit complicated, but if you think logically, you will see it is very easy to understand. Here you can see 1s, we have shown the 1s also. And 1s is having sigma and sigma star. For 2s and 2p, they are closely spaced, and 2px orbital is mixed up to giving 2 hybridized spx orbital. So 2sp1 and 2sp2. And other 2pyz remain as same. So this is the hybridization. Here also same figure you can see. Now, as it is hybridized, 2px is giving sigma 2p with the 2px, sigma and sigma star. And then the pi lobe is coming over here. Another sigma you can see here below that pi, and then here is 1 pi and 1 sigma star. The figure is clear to you?
Sir, figure is a bit complicated. Please repeat. Which orbitals are mixing?
Okay, let us enlarge this one. Now it is clear? See,
yes, sir.
First 2p and 2s is mixed up. 1px orbital is mixed up to give 2 hybridized orbital, same number of hybrid orbital we are getting. 2px, here is 3px, py, pz orbital is present. So px is mixed up with s to give px1, px2. One is lower energy, one is higher energy. Is it clear? Same situation you can draw here. And pyz is present as it is, without interacting the S. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, as the energy is very much lower, so the sigma and sigma star having this position. And another sigma is here. However, sigma star is higher than the pi. It is the relative energy position depending on the after hybridization. Okay, first, here is a sigma SPX hybridized, then another sigma bonding hybridized, because sigma bonding is lower energy than pi, and then two pi orbital bonding, then one sigma antibonding, then two pi antibonding, and then one sigma antibonding. One sigma antibonding is lower than the pi antibonding because of lowering the energy. This is the only effect due to hybridization. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so please you sit with this figure and try to understand. If you face any problem, I will clear in the next class. Means if there is any problem, we may discuss further in the next class. Okay. So here, if you try to put the B2 electrons, it is 1s is having 2 electrons, so 2 is placed in bonding antibonding. Now 2s is having 2 electron, and 1p is having 1 electron. So 3 electron here. Now in hybridized orbital, you have to fill similar way. Means here is 2 and here is 1. Similarly, here is 2, here is 1. Okay. Now, when we are putting the electrons, 2 electron is here, here is 2 electron, 4, and 1 electron is present here, 2, 3, 3, 6. So one single electron is occupied in p orbital. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And here is all is connected. So you can see that from here it is connected. As it is hybridized, so all we have connected with each other. Connection is also important. Okay. And that is why BE2 is paramagnetic, not the diamagnetic, due to having the lone pair of electrons. So you can explain without considering hybridization, with considering hybridization. But better to explain with considering hybridization, because when we will discuss the other molecule like heteronuclear diatomic molecule, then you must have to consider the hybridization. That is why you should preferably explain using hybridization. Okay. So similarly, you can draw the molecular orbital diagram and you can calculate the bond order for C2N2. You may draw the same molecular orbital for oxygen also, or you may draw the previous one. For oxygen, you may draw the previous one. No need to draw the hybridized. Okay, because here in case of oxygen and fluorine, as electronegativity increases, so 2s energy is decreased with respect to the 2p. And that is why the energy gap increases and this is having the normal structure. You can see the energy gap 16-18. That is why they are having the normal diagram. Okay, so you can try to solve those problems. draw the AMO diagram for oxide and calculate that. I have already given you H2N2O2F2, all are gases under standard condition. Which of these gases are paramagnetic? Which do you expect will have the stronger bond? So you have to explain after drawing the molecular orbital diagram and placing the electron. We have to calculate the bond order and you can say which one is having the stronger bond. Draw the molecular orbital diagram of Be2+ and Be2 2-. Here it should be probably Be2, not Be2 2+ and Be2 2-. And determine the bond order. Do these ions exist? What is the bond order for the disulfide ion? Do you expect ion to be paramagnetic or diamagnetic? Okay, so you may try to solve this question. Okay. Now we will consider the molecular orbital diagram of heteronuclear diatomic molecule. Means both the atom is different, like LiH, HX, CN, CO, NO. LiH and HX is the simple one, and BN, CN, CO, NO is the complex one. Here we are considering the two types. One type, one S atom overlapping with other S or P. And type 2 is both sp orbital is interacting, like BN, CN, CO, NO. Both are having sp orbital. And type 1 is having s orbital only and with other having sp orbital. Okay, so first we will consider in type 1. Whatever be, either it is type 1 or type 2, you have to consider when you are drawing the relative energy level diagram. This is relative energy level diagram. So when you are drawing it, you have to consider that the atom having high electronegativity with respect to others, not that both are electropositive like hydrogen and lithium, but one is electronegative with respect to other. So the electronegative atom with respect to other should have the lower energy position. Okay, in case of homonuclear, it is we have drawn in same energy level, because 2s of one atom is having the same energy 2s of other. But in case of when here is the electronegativity difference, like lithium H, the H is electronegative than lithium. So H should be placed in lower energy. You can see H1s is here and lithium-1s is here, little higher in position, because lithium is electropositive with respect to hydrogen. Similarly, बात करें अगर placements के बारे में तो आपका is it clear? 3 years का मतलब जो starting में आपका 6 semester का aggregate होता है.
Yes sir.
तो वो देखा जाता है जो starting में cream companies आती हैं. So here for lithium hydride, the lithium 2s is having one electron, so 2s is interacting with 1s, and here we have also shown the hybridization in lithium. Like the boron carbon nitrogen. Okay, so due to a hybridization, the mixed up and lower energy, lower hybridized orbital is overlapping 1s of the hydrogen. to give one bonding and one antibody. Here is no other orbital is available to interact, and that is why those are directly transfer into the molecular orbital. This situation is called non-bonding orbitals, molecular orbitals. When it is not interacting with other molecule and directly coming over the molecular orbital diagram, it is called non-bonding. And to draw the non-bonding electrons, you should not change the energy level. Is it clear? Because here orbital is not available for the hydrogen to interact with the other orbitals of lithium. So these are placed as non-bonding orbitals in the molecular orbital. Is it clear? So here 2s is having one electrons and hydrogen 1s is having one electron. Those are placed in bonding orbital. So non-bonding and anti-bonding remain free. And bond order is 1 for lithium hydride.
तो एक तो होता है फील लेके पढ़ना, मतलब आपको सब्जेक्ट में इंटरेस्ट आ रहा है, आपको फिजिक्स में इंटरेस्ट आ रहा है, तो पूरे
इज इट क्लियर
पढ़ रहे हो, हर एक चीज पढ़ रहे हो, इन डेप्थ जा रहे हो, बिल्कुल
yes, sir.
कोई बुरी बात
नाउ इन केस ऑफ H6
ऐसे भी पढ़ सकते हो, मैथमेटिक्स में
इंटरेस्ट घुस के पढ़ना. हाइड्रोजन इज इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू X, इफ X इज FClBrI
एंड बुरी बात अच्छी बात है, CGPA जरूरी है. अगर आप लोग ऐसे पढ़ना चाहते हो तो सबसे पहली चीज भाई पूरे चैप्टर
इट इज एफ इज इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव देन द हाइड्रोजन, सो हाइड्रोजन 1s इज प्लेस अबव
आ जाएगा कि मतलब यार ये टॉपिक्स लिखे
एंड इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी एज द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस इज वेरी हाई द एनर्जी इज डिफरेंस शुड बी आल्सो हाई. सो एज वेरी हाई इन इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस इवन टू पी इज प्लेस्ड इन लोअर और एनपी फॉर क्लोरीन इट इज 3p प्लेस lower than 1s. So 1s is interacting with the higher hybridized orbital. Because hybridized orbital, the p orbital which is mixed up with s can only form the sigma bond. Which is pure is not from the sigma bond, that will form the pi bond only. So higher orbital, because it is close to 1s, why it is not forming the bond with the lower? Because lower is now lower in energy, so it is interacting with the higher energy hybridized
orbital.
And so here is one sigma bonding, one sigma antibonding, and this is not interacting, so non-bonding, and 2p is also not interacting, non-bonding. And when you are filling up electron, here 5 electron is present in case of fluorine and 1 electron is present hydrogen, so total 6. So 2 in sigma bonding, 2 in sigma non-bonding, and 4 in pi non-bonding. Now how to calculate the bond order? To calculate the bond order, do not count the non-bonding electrons. Non-bonding electrons is not having any influence on the bond order. So you only count the bonding electrons minus antibonding. Antibonding is 0, so 2 by 2 equal to 1. HF is having the 1 covalent bond between them.
तो हाँ यार मैंने फर्स्ट ईयर
सिमिलरली HCl HBr इज सेम फिगर ओनली द NP इज डिफरेंट NS एंड NP इज डिफरेंट.
अब गाइस मोस्ट ऑफ द कॉलेजेस में HC तनेजा ही कराई जाती है.
एक्सक्यूज मी सर,
अपने सीनियर से भी जरूर.
यस प्लीज
सर, कुड यू एक्सप्लेन द प्रोसेस वंस अगेन, लाइक इन लिथियम हाइड्राइड सर, फर्स्ट दे आर हाइब्रिडाइज्ड और कैन यू एक्सप्लेन दैट पार्ट वंस.
यस I understand your question. Probably you are asking that in lithium hydride, why the lower hybridized orbital is bonding? Whereas in case of HCl, why the higher hybridized orbital is bonding? And how we can consider which one will bond with the other? दिस इज योर क्वेश्चन. सो हियर इट डिपेंड्स ऑन इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस. हियर हाइड्रोजन इज इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव देन लिथियम एंड लिथियम इज हैविंग द हाइब्रिडाइज्ड ऑर्बिटल.
अब अगर मैं फिजिक्स के कुछ यूट्यूब
चैनल की बात बताऊं, तो क्लोज पोजीशन ऑर्बिटल विल ओवरलैप.
वो टॉपिक वाला सीन बता
दो. नोअर एनर्जी इज क्लोज पोजीशन विद वन. यस,
मैंने जस्ट एक टॉपिक डाल के पढ़ लिया था, लेकिन यार कुछ यूट्यूब
चैनल नोअर हाइब्रिडाइज्ड. सो दे विल ओवर. हियर Cl इज इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव
एंड एक चांस है टेक्निकल फिजिक्स.
एंड
तो आप ये दोनों चांस भी फॉलो कर
सकते हैं. H इज वेरी मच इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिव. सो 1s ऑर्बिटल इट इज वेरी हायर एनर्जी रिलेटिव एनर्जी पोजीशन एंड इट इज closer with the higher energy. If electronegativity difference is, I have already mentioned that depend on the electronegativity difference. If electronegativity difference is very high, they are energy separation is also very high. As hydrogen is very much electropositive with respect to the halogens, 1s is even higher position than 4p or 5p, near to 5p. Same position. Is it clear? And that is why higher hybridized orbital is close to 1s, not the lower one. Lower one is higher, much higher distance than 1s. Is it clear?
And electrical में थोड़ा बहुत in depth जाना है, तो आप लोग follow कर सकते हो. और
okay, so please try to understand sitting.
लेकिन यार मैंने books से पढ़ा नहीं.
Take those figures, print out or in computer and sit alone to understand it. If you are unable to understand, then I will make it clear in the next class. Okay? And we will also consider the MO diagram for other molecules.
मेरे को बिल्कुल पसंद नहीं आया, मतलब मजा नहीं आया इस सब्जेक्ट
में. सो इफ यू डू नॉट हैव एनी क्वेरी, वी कैन लीव नाउ.
बनाते हुए भी आपको ए लेटर लिखते हुए बहुत सारी चीजों का ध्यान.
थैंक यू टू ऑल ऑफ यू.
बहुत टाइम लग जाता था. अब यार मैंने
थैंक यू सर
दोस्त से बनवा ली थी शीट्स वैसे, तो अगर आप भी दोस्त से बनवा सकते हो तो वेल एंड गुड भाई.